Hi.
Hey there.
Hey there.
Let's create a connection and enjoy the ride. Come join us here at Open Minds.
In our previous lesson, we talked about the environment, and we saw how we can do every day to improve the environment and to reduce pollution. But now we have to talk about a possible consequence of having a polluted environment, which is climate change. Scientists are not completely sure about what causes climate change. Most scientists interested in this subject believe that human activity is speeding up, so it's accelerating climate change. When the sunlight enters the Earth's atmosphere, it passes through a layer of greenhouse gases. Greenhouse gases occur, so happen naturally, but humans also create them by burning fossil fuels. And what are going to be the effects of climate change? Have you ever thought about that? So if the climate is changing, temperatures are getting higher and higher every year, the glaciers, so in the North Pole, ice is melting and it's becoming water. What do you think it will happen in 50, 100, 150 years? Think about it for 1 minute. So I think that you don't have a very clear idea of what's gonna happen. In fact, it is very difficult to predict what will happen as the temperature rises. However, scientists believe the world's glaciers will melt into the ocean, causing sea levels to rise drastically, so to rise a lot. Most people are terrified of the terrible effects that this could have on the world we live in. You worried about climate change and its possible consequences? Before going on with our discussion, I would like to play an environment and climate change quiz together. So I will read you the questions and you will have to try to guess the answer. Let's start. What do you call the area that is inhabited by particular species, habitat, environment, or biosphere? Habitat, correct. What do you call the processing of used materials and their reuse? Recycling, reusing, reprocessing? Recycling. Which layer protects the Earth from UV rays? Oxygen, nitrogen, ozone? Ozone. The process by which the Earth's temperature is increasing is called greenhouse effect. Which of the following is biodegradable? Plastic, paper, or glass? Paper. What is the term for the complete disappearance of a species? Extinction. What do you call renewable safe sources of energy? Alternative energies. Which of these energy sources is renewable? Wind. What do you call the rain that contains many chemicals and is harmful? Harmful means that dangerous. So which one? A, B or C? B. What do you call a substance that pollutes the air, water or soil? How do you call it? Acid. What is the most used renewable energy source in the world? If you look at the picture, you will guess the answer. Hydro energy. Hydro means water. Which of these animals is not in danger of becoming extinct? I don't know this answer. Do you know this answer? If you know the answer, can you let me know, please? Question number 13. What type of shopping bag is more eco-friendly? A paper bag, a plastic bag, or none of them? Maybe paper bag is better than a plastic bag, but it's even better if you have your own bag. So made of cotton, of linen, that you can use many times. Global warming will cause an increase of heat waves, hurricanes, or both of them? I would say both of them. Which gas is responsible for global warming? Which one is it? If you don't know, check your science book and find out the answer. I'm not giving it to you. Let's see if you guess it. What are some of the consequences of deforestation? I think it's both. Which of the following is not a fossil fuel? Coal, wood, or oil? That's another good question to go and check on your science book. Which of these human activities contributes the most for global warming? I know this answer is using fossil fuels. Which of the following can be recycled? Milk cartons, plastic bottles, or both? Of course, this is easy. Both of them can be recyclable. Which is the following animals that hasn't extinct yet? It's the rhino. The tiger is a very old animal that doesn't exist anymore, that used to live in Australia and Tasmania and New Guinea. And finally, rainforest land is most often cleared for... So when you have a forest, they cut trees in favor of farmlands. So how many did you guess? Did you take note? Let me know. I know that climate change is very dangerous, and we need to do something in our own life, in our daily routine, to protect it. So here is a reading about small things that you can do in your daily routine to save the environment, to do something to live in a better world in the future. I hope you will enjoy the reading, and I will see you next week. Bye bye.